gotta ask both of y'all a question. You two brothers, I gotta ask y'all a question. Is y'all aware of the shooting that just took place? Did you watch the news?
Yeah.
You watched the news? Is you aware that the shooting that happened in Denver, Colorado, did that pop up on your news feed? You aware of it? He went in there and he shot all and killed all the people. What did they do to him? Did you see the footage of them bringing him out the stove with his leg bloody? Okay, so I'm bring you up to speed. So when they got him from out the grocery store and he went in there, he had an AR-15 or AK, some type of high power rifle, and he went in there and shot over and killed over 10 people. So he went over there and he killed over 10 people. So when they brought him out, his leg was bloody and they had a gurney and they propped the gurney up and they set him on the gurney and they took him into custody, they took him to jail. Do you feel like that is something that happened when the other nations, the so-called white man, how they go in there and they do this mass shooting and he come out the stove and he still make it to the jail alive? Is that a trend that happened amongst the white people when they go and do these mass murders? Yeah. It always happened like that,
yeah,
don't it?
Uh-huh. Yeah, but if that'd be a black man, they might shoot us, kill us on the spot, and if a black man go in the stove and shoot and kill 10 people, and the police come, they're gonna shoot that black man.
Right.
Because he's black.
Right. And we don't even have to have a weapon. You gotta think. A lot of our killings that took place with Trayvon Martin, George Floyd, all of these, Tamir Rice, all of these people did not have weapons.
Bring it up.
They didn't even pose a threat to the police officers.
That's right.
Because they didn't have a weapon on them.
Bring
but
it up.
The other nations, they have high power rifles that they use in the military, and still they don't die or they don't get killed at the scene when the police go ahead. And I'm gonna show you why that happens amongst our people. The Bible is going to explain why that take place with our people. Give me Amos 3:1. Because it's important that we know this so we can have the visual of who we are in this Bible and why we going through the things that we go through. You got to look, and when you pay attention, you watch the news and see the things that's going on, and you see our people through the community and what we going through, you got to go back to the Bible, and it all relates and tie into the Bible why we going through the press and the things that we going through. Read that.
This is the book of Amos, chapter 3 and verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Hear this word that the Lord hath spoken against you, O children of Israel.
Oh, who?
O children of Israel.
Because if you don't know it, we are the Israelites. We are the children of Israel. The so-called blacks who you get see shot down when they are armed, when they don't have weapons on them, they are the Israelites. The so-called Hispanics who you see get shot down, get locked up by ICE, Immigration and Customs, they are the children of Israel.
Bring it out!
The so-called Native Americans who you see get oppressed, pushed in the corners on a reservation, now with all type of addictions and suicide rates, they are the children of Israel.
Bring it out!
Read it again from the top.
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you,
Bible say, hear this word, which means hear the Bible. Read.
Against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt.
Because when you go back to the history from the beginning, Moses brought us out of the land of Egypt. If you know anything about the Bible, read.
Saying, you only have I known.
Saying what?
You only have I known.
No, the Bible said that God know all nations and families on earth.
You only have I know.
God said he only known the Israelites, the blacks, Hispanics, and the Native Americans.
That's right.
That's only who God have ever known. Read.
You only have I know of all the families of the earth.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, I will punish you.
Therefore what?
I will punish you.
God say that's why he's gonna punish us, because he only known us. So when you see them coming out of the stores and they feed them McDonald's, prepping up the gurneys for them, taking them in there, they never shoot them down, and they got these rifles and loaded guns on them, but you see us constantly getting killed and shot down, and we don't even have a weapon. We pose no threat, because God say he only have known us.
That's right.
Give me Hosea 4:1. Yeah, finish it out. But listen, that's because God gave us law, statutes, and commandments to keep. So once we went outside of that, because of this image that I was telling you about earlier, along with that spirit came, we ain't gotta abide by the God of this Bible rules.
Bring it out.
We gonna do abide by the so-called white Jesus rules, which means you can do whatever you wanna do, you can live how you wanna live.
Preach.
You don't have to keep the Sabbath day, you don't have to do anything that the Bible tell you to do, and you still go be accepted by the white Jesus. Not by the black Messiah according to the Bible.
That's right.
Read.
Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
For what?
For all your iniquities.
Iniquities means sin.
That's right.
God said he go punish us for all our sin. So not keeping it, when you wake up and you going out shopping and buying, going to the liquor stores, going shopping, cash your paycheck on Friday, and you go spend it on Saturday, that is iniquity. That's sin. According to the Bible. We not, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans is not supposed to do that. Because God gave us law, statutes, and commandment. And I'm going to prove you that. Give me Psalm 147. Give me Psalms 147, 19 to 20. And stand here and listen. Well, when you listening, take your head off while the scripture's coming out. And I'm gonna show you that later on. It's good to not have your head covered when we reading the Bible, when we bringing the scriptures out.
That's right. All praises.
That's a sign of repentance right there, if you don't know it or not. Read.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 147 and verse 19.
Read.
He showeth his word unto Jacob.
It said he showeth his word unto Jacob. This is Jacob right here. These 12 tribes down here. Jacob is the forefather in each one of those tribes on that side. His word is the Bible. So he said he showeth the Bible unto all 12 of those tribes that's on that side right there. Read.
His statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
His statutes, which is his laws, unto Israel. In the judgment for breaking those laws, unto Israel. Israel is the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and the Native Americans.
That's Read. Right. He hath not dealt so with any nation.
Oh, wait one second. Did you hear what that said? Read it again.
He hath not dealt so with any nation.
It say he has not dealt so with any nation. The topic is him showing his words unto the 12 tribes, unto Jacob.
That's
it
right.
It say he have not dealt so with any other nation. So that's why we always want, that's why we number one in incarceration. The blacks and Hispanics, we fill the prisons up. That's why we number one in diabetes. If you could just Google it on your phone. Our people is the number one top of the chart in incarceration, in health, diabetes, and black on black crimes. We at the top of the chart of everything. Why? Because we study breaking God's commandments. STDs, everything. And that's why, because we don't know who we are according to the Bible.
Bring it
we
up.
Still walking around thinking that we so-called African Americans, which we not African Americans. African Americans come from two Caucasian men.
That's right.
And there's no way that two men alone can even have a child to even start a nation, and then a white man's at that to create a whole black nation.
Preach.
It's impossible.
Bring it out.
Read that again from the top.
He hath not dealt so with any nation.
Read.
And as for his judgments, they have not known them.
They have not known them. So when you see that, when you see the man come out of there, Denver, Colorado, and they prop the gurney up for him, they lay him down on the bed, and they take him in to the jail cell and talk to him and plead with him peacefully, and put them in a cell, is because they have not known the judgments of God.
That's right.
So when you see us getting jacked up time after time after time after time, it's for the Most High to make you examine yourself so we can get ourselves right and say, why is I'm going through this? Why all my relationships, they go sour? Why every time I get fired, I'm going from job to job, I seem like I'm always struggling, I can never get ahead? That's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to examine yourself. Give me Hosea 4:1. Give me Hosea 4:1. So you have to understand that the God of this Bible, or the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and the Native American, he has a problem with us the way that we live it, going about our own thoughts, doing our own way. We can't do our own way. We have to do the way of God. That's how we go come back and reunite as a nation and stand up and get out of the captivity that we're in today.
That's right.
Don't know, it's not, it don't feel good to be oppressed and study being at the bottom in the midst of the ghettos. You have to understand, we was once a top nation above all nations on the earth.
Bring
That's
it
what
up.
The Bible say. God chose us to be above all.
That's right.
Read that.
This is the book of Hosea, chapter 4, verse 1.
Read.
Hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel.
Ye who?
You children of Israel.
No, the Chinese.
Ye children of Israel.
The white man.
Ye children of Israel.
Israel is the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
That's right.
Just say, hear these words. Read.
For the Lord hath a controversy with the inhabitants of the land.
You know what a controversy is? What's that? A controversy. It say the Lord has a controversy. You know what that is? A controversy mean a problem. That mean God has a problem with the children of Israel. Yeah, that's in the Bible. Read it again. It's gonna tell you why. Read it again. That's a good question. The Bible gonna explain why he has a problem with the children of Israel, the blacks, Hispanics, and the Native American. Read it.
For the Lord has a controversy.
A problem.
With the inhabitants of the land.
The so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Read.
Because there is no truth, nor mercy, nor knowledge of God in the land.
That's why he has a problem. Because there's no truth, no knowledge, no mercy of God in the land.
Bring it
That's
up.
Why we out here today, to bring that truth and the knowledge of God to our brothers and to our sisters as well. Read.
By swearing and lying and
read.
And killing.
It said by swearing and lying. Does not our people do that? Come on, we grew up in the hood. We know that. We know plenty liars. We know plenty people that, oh man, I swear, man, when I get my check, I'm gonna take care of you. Then they get their check, you never see them again.
Bring it out.
Now you chasing them all around, looking at them. Now you developing some type of anger or hatred. Now you want to put your hands on them because he's swearing to you and he done lied and ran off because he owe you some money.
That's right.
That's against God. That's against the laws of the Bible. That's why God has a problem with us, because us being brothers, we don't supposed to deal with each other like that.
Bring it out.
Read. Read it again from the top.
By swearing, but in lying.
Read.
And killing.
And killing. What do they call Chicago? Chirac, right? To have more killings than Iraq, which is a third world country that's known for war.
That's right.
Read it again.
And by swearing, and lying, and killing.
And killing. And the killing come because we have, hold that. Give me Leviticus 17. It said, and by killing. We don't supposed to be killing each other. That killing each other come because we have hatred. We have hatred in our hearts for our brothers. That's why we killing. That's why it takes nothing to load up a gun and go shoot a man down 17, 18 times who look just like you, because you have hatred in your heart for that man.
Bring it out.
Read that.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 19 and verse 17.
Read.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart.
It said, thou should not hate thy brother in thy heart. According to the Bible, the heart is the mind. When you read Mark 7 and 21.
That's right.
It's nothing. This is just the organ that pumps blood.
Bring it out.
The thoughts starts right here in the mind. It say that you should not hate your brother in the heart or in your mind. Read.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
It say rebuke me is to correct your neighbor. You see your brother going off like, man, bro, that you shouldn't be selling drugs to the old lady up the street, man. You know, that's you shouldn't be doing that. You killing her body. That's rebuking your neighbor, and that's saving your brother and not having hatred for your brother according to the scriptures. Because according to the scriptures, drop that, give me Romans 6 and 23. Because according to the scriptures, when you lie your brother to continue in sin and go in sin, God will judge him and put him to death for sin. Did you know that? You know that? Yes, God will judge you and kill you for being in the midst of sin. That's why when you see our communities jacked up like this, it's because when we read in Amos 3, because of our iniquities, that we going through the trials and the things that we going through in our community. Read that.
This is the book of Romans chapter 6 and verse 23.
Read.
For the wages of sin is death.
For what?
For the wages of sin is death.
The wages of, what's a wage? What is a wage?
A price.
A wage? A wage is, it's like, so when you go to a job.
Oh yeah, minimum wage, that's like $13. $13 an hour.
So who gets the minimum? It's a wage is a payment. So like if you go to a job, they tell you your wages when you first get hired. They tell you what your wages and what you're gonna be making and what you can possibly increase to. And then they issue those wages out to you weekly or bi-weekly. But what did the Bible say wages for sin is? Read.
For the wages of sin is death.
So the payment for sins is death.
Bring it out.
So when you see our people die at a mass rate, that's because we are in the midst of sin.
Bring it out.
We're going against God's commandments. We are breaking the laws of God.
That's right.
That's why we jacked up as a nation. Give me Leviticus 21 and 5. I'm gonna bring out some sins so that we can understand some of the things when you leave here today that we must be keeping so we can save ourselves from death. As I just read in Leviticus 19, that's how you're supposed to rebuke your brother. That's called love. When you correct your brother according to the Bible. Read.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 21 and verse 5.
Read.
They shall not make baldness upon their head.
Uh-huh.
Neither shall they shave off the corners of their beard.
So it say that you're not supposed to have a Michael Jordan, a Montel Williams. When you just shave, getting a straight razor, you just bald in your head. You're not supposed to do that according to the Bible. Why? Because it's a commandment of God. He told the children of Israel, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, don't do it. So you just don't supposed to do it. Like when you growing up in your father, your mother household, they have rules and regulations and things for you not to do as they bring you up. And you're supposed to honor your mother and father. They say, listen, I don't want you out past 9 o'clock. So before 9 o'clock come, you make sure you're in the house so you can respect your mother and father. It's the same thing with us and the Most High.
Bring it out.
Read.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
So you're not supposed to mar the beard either. So as you can see, a lot of us, we let our beards grow full. You can trim it down. You can trim it down low, but you're not supposed to mark. You're not supposed to shave or cut into the natural lining of the beard. You're supposed to let it grow out, or you're supposed to trim it down low, but not mark into the natural growth of the beard. Why? Because the Bible say not to do that. Read the last line on that. When it say the cut is in the flesh.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
Nor make any cuttings in their flesh. That goes into tattoos. Now, a lot of us got tattoos before we heard the Bible, before we heard this truth. Because why? Because we didn't know any better.
Bring
we
it
didn't
out.
Know that that was in the Bible.
Bring it out.
A lot of us had chin straps, go to the barber, get the lined up chin straps. Why? Because we didn't know that was in the Bible. We didn't know any better. But when we heard the Bible come out, we changed. We was like, you know what? If God has a problem with me doing that, I'ma change. Why? Because I fear the Lord.
Bring it out.
I fear when I read Romans 6 and 23 and it say the wages of sin is death. I don't want to get put to death. I don't want God to put me to death. So if I don't want God to put me to death, I have to change and I have to live my life according to how God say to live. Correct?
Bring it out.
Read it again.
This is the book of Leviticus chapter 21 and verse 5.
Read.
They shall not make baldness upon their head.
Uh-huh.
Neither shall they shave off the corners of their beard.
Neither should they shave off the corners of their beard. So these is the things that we have to come back to as being Israel. So when let me ask you a question. When the brother was up here, did he prove to you that you understand how you know that you is Israel? So how do you know that you Israel? Did he prove to you how you know you Israel? Let me ask you a question. What's your nationality? Your nationality. When you go fill out an application, what do you put on there? That'd be considered a nationality. Far as your race.
You African American.
What would you say your nationality is?
I'm an Israelite.
You're Israelite. Okay, all praise. So give me Isaiah 1:3. These is the first signs of knowing and identifying and placing yourself in this Bible, knowing that you're an Israelite. Based off, you said you put African American, you said you put African American. Read that.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 1 and verse 3.
Read.
The ox knows his owner, and the ass his master's crib.
It say the ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master cribs. An ox is a dumb animal. An ox is an animal that's dumb, it's just big and strong. And the ass is his master crib, like a donkey or jackass. You can take set the jackass, the donkey, right? This can be the donkey's home right here on 47. And you can take it all the way to 115th and Michigan. And that donkey is gonna know how to find his way right back here to 47th in Indiana.
Because
that's the nature of the jackass. He's gonna know how to get back home. That's instilled in him. Read it again from the top.
The ox knows his owner.
Read.
And the ass his master's crib.
Read.
But Israel.
But who?
But Israel.
But who?
But Israel.
But Israel, the blacks, the Hispanics, and Native Americans, they don't know what?
Not know.
They don't know. They don't know that it's the God of the Bible of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That's who we belong to.
That's right.
They don't know that. They think they belong to the man right there who, when you first came up, the white man on the picture as Christ. That's who they think they belong to. And with that thought and that process, it put a different spirit on them. Then they start living contrary to how God say to live. And that's what we out here to do. We out here to show our people who they are according to the Bible, teach them their nationality, teach them the laws, and teach them how to change from out the state of mind that they in. How to come back to the Bible and repent, which means to change your actions and your ways from how you used to live it into how God ordained you to live.
Bring it out.
As kings, as gods on the earth.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.